Heyo, it's Abby, and it's been a while, but we are back with two new, well, new to me, Poppin' Cookins. I think they have been out for a while, but obviously, we have taken a break from these for, a few years, and I thought these were perfect for Valentine's, a little tray of sweets and a little chocolate fondue party. I kind of feel like the chocolate fondue party is going to be a little bit easier. Oh yeah, it says, oh, also, I tore my fingernails, so please ignore that. But this is 4 stars, and this is 5 stars difficulty. So let's start with the 4 stars. Oh, looks like the bag is the tray. We are going back to our roots. Let me cut this open. Here are the contents. Strawberry chocolate sauce, chocolate sauce, cake mix, marshmallows. Ooh, I wonder if these are like Lucky Charms marshmallows. And then we have banana base and strawberry jelly base. Bag of sprinkles, toothpicks for the fondue, a spoon, and the tray. Don't throw away the bag because you'll be using it as a guide for the bananas and for the cake, and then also as a tray. I'm gonna go ahead and cut it apart. Our water cup. It's kind of hard to see the tray on the light background. We'll start with this cup for the strawberries, the mold for the strawberries, and the water cup. Is that enhanced enough? You know what? I've kind of missed making these kits. I am worried it's not going to turn out like it's supposed to. One triangle of water. It smells really good, so we're going to mix it right away. It says it'll start to harden after 10 minutes. I'm going to use this as a tray because I can't see anything on the camera. We're going to pour the strawberry into here. Let's dollop it in. We can push it in and scrape it. Did you guys ever have those scented, and they weren't even beads, they were just like dots. I had strawberry scented ones like this, I feel like. I think I waited a little too long. It's cutting out that background sheet. It's all very chunky now. Okay, and the strawberries are prepped. Let them sit there and harden. Next, we make the bananas in here. One triangle of water and banana powder. That smells like banana, but like artificial candy bananas. Now we mix this. I think we use this mold for the cake too. Now you're going to want to make sure your fingers and hands are clean. Take this out. And then we're going to knead it a little bit and roll it into a ball. We're going to use this guide here. I'm just going to roll it out a little bit. Make it look like a banana. Is that about right? There's our little banana worm. Now we cut it diagonally. There are our banana slices. Let's move on to the cake. You know what? It can be slightly banana flavored cake. One triangle of water and cake powder. Ooh, smells like vanilla. Oh, I remember this smell. Poppin' Cookin' donuts, Poppin' Cookin' cake. This is the magic cake powder. Now we mix it together. Now it says tap it 10 times to get the air bubbles out. I'm gonna go pop this into the microwave for 20 seconds. Back from the microwave, it's all puffy, it's like a steamed cake. We're gonna let it cool a little bit and go ahead and make the chocolate sauce. This time we're gonna do 2 scoops of water each. 1, 2. We'll do both sides at once. 1, 2. First, the strawberry powder. Oh, that's a lot of powder. There's some strawberry bits in it. Maybe we'll mix them one at a time just to prevent a mess. This is a fun idea, a little chocolate fondue party with Poppin' Cookin'. If you've seen any other fun sets, let me know and I'll try to find them. There is our strawberry chocolate. Kind of looks like yogurt. Ooh, that looks good. It's like hot cocoa mix. I know that since I started making Poppin' Cookin' videos that they have exported these to different countries. I know that there's like English packaging versions of them. I thought that was really cool when I saw them when I visited America. And there was a different version of these. It wasn't Poppin' Cookin', it was made by a different company. What was it called? They were like little cooking kits like this. Ooh, this chocolate sauce is looking good. Apparently we're supposed to microwave it for 10 seconds. So maybe it'll melt a little bit. I just want to make sure it's all mixed in. So we'll microwave this, but I want to prep the ingredients first. Let's see if the cake has cooled enough. It says take a toothpick and go around the edges. Oh, I think it's going to come out. Oh, there's a cutting board sheet over here. Okay, let's pull it out. Look at that. I'm going to trim off the excess here and make it look a little bit nicer. Looks good. I guess we follow the guidelines and cut it in half. I don't want to squish it too much. It's very spongy. Okay, that keeps its shape. Oh, they look like little hearts. How cute. Shall we demold our strawberries? Right here it says Ichigo Zeri. Let's see if these will pop out. Oh yeah, little strawberries. Whoops. That's where the bananas go. You can't go over there. I can't wait to dip those in the chocolate sauce. Next we have the banana slices. There, they look yummy. Look at this little fondue party. They said to put sprinkles in this cup. And finally, we have the marshmallows. Let's see what these look like. They're little baby marshmallows. Oh my goodness, there's so many. Okay, stay in your area, little marshmallows. I don't know if these are freeze-dried. No, they're soft. Look at, they're squishy. They're not like Lucky Charms marshmallows. Whoops, I'm gonna eat one. They're really good. I'm gonna go microwave this for 10 seconds. I'll be right back. Alrighty, I am back. Let's put the tray here. It's warm now. What should we dip first? Let's try a cake. Oops. Dipped in the chocolate sauce. Oh, that's gonna be yummy. Look at that. Oh my goodness, that chocolate sauce. It's delicious. I think Poppin' Cookin's have improved since the last time I made them. Let's put some sprinkles on it. Look at that. Well, you can't see. There you go. Look at that. Let's try the banana. This feels like a real fondue. That's pretty good. The banana flavor is there. I like the chocolate better than the strawberry, but the strawberry isn't bad. I just like chocolate a lot. Look how fun that is. Okay, oops. 5 out of 5 were the Poppin' Cookin' fondue. Because when I first saw it, I was like, well, what am I supposed to do with it? It's just you make the chocolate sauce and dip things, but I like that you get to make the ingredients yourself. And the tiny marshmallows are so good. Poppin' Cookin's are still about the same price. They're about 300 yen, I believe. This is a fun snack. It's yummy, and you get to make it yourself. Now let's make the fancy chocolates. Box number 2. It looks like we are going to be a fancy little cake shop. It says you can be a chocolatier. Chocolatier. This looks a little scary. It says you need hot water. And I know we need to let stuff sit in the fridge for about 10 minutes. So there are a lot more steps on this one compared to this one. Let me read this real quick. I can definitely do this. This is supposed to be for kids, right? Oh, here's the chocolate tray. What do we have on the back? Oh, examples. Okay. I'm scared. Ta-da! Okay, here is the chocolate that needs to be melted. It said double boiler it. Two of those. Strawberry mousse base. Caramel cream base. Orange jelly and strawberry jelly. Sweet powder. Chocolate mousse base. Okay, there's a lot. Here we have a spoon and the tray. That looks pretty cool. I don't know if it helps, but let's try using the cutting board. I'm gonna cut out the trays that we need, aka all of them. We'll cut off the water cup. And then these fruit molds. Here is the chocolate tray, the tart tray. This doesn't sit flat though. That kind of bothers me. Does that not matter? It doesn't say anything, so I guess it's fine. Fruit tray, and then who knows what tray. I assume these are the molds. Let me go get some hot water. I have some hot water that I got out of my coffee machine. Going to dunk these into the hot water. You don't want boiling water. The package said about 50 degrees Celsius, so just warm water. I'm hoping this is enough. Might have to go add some more. Just let it melt. Alrighty, they've been sitting in here and I think they have melted. What it says to do is fold it and then cut the tip here to pipe it out. Okay, and then I'm gonna pipe it into these trays. Ooh. Some decoration chocolate, another tart. This is actually very well made because there's a little bit of air in the bag already, so it makes it easy to push the chocolate out. And then we tap it down. I'm gonna stop touching that one. Let's do this one. This one, I don't like how it leans, but I think it's okay. I'm just gonna leave it like this for now, so it's a little even. We'll pop it in the fridge after we do this one. This one's a little bit easier because cut it off. Ah! Chocolate! Then we just pour all of it in. Chocolate all over my scissors! There is a lower line to the water cup this time. We fill it with water and pour it in. That's kind of scary to pour water into chocolate. And this is gonna make it into nama choco. More of a kind of truffle, ganache? I don't know the English word. Here we call it nama choco. It's like raw chocolate. Oh good, I was worried it was gonna separate. Let's tap this one down too. And it says 10 minutes in the fridge. So let me clean up this mess and pop everything into the fridge. While the chocolate is in the fridge, we are going to whip up the rest of the ingredients. First, we're gonna make more strawberry. 2 cups of water this time. 1, 2. This time we will work fast. Jelly powder, mix, mix, mix. Let that all dissolve. We pour it into the strawberry tray and the mousse tray. Strawberry. They're so tiny. And then it says pour the rest into the square tray. Here we go. Just dab that in here. Try to clean this out as best as we can because I think we use it again. Okay, there is the mousse tray and the strawberries. Two more triangles of water. One, two. Strawberry mousse powder. Oh, this doesn't smell good. It smells like gelatin. Doesn't really smell like strawberries. Mix, mix, mix. You gonna turn pink? I think it is. Interesting. It's not dissolving as well. I guess it's okay though. It smells kind of yogurty. Let's pour this over. Okay, that is the second layer. Next is the chocolate mousse. One, two. Poppin' Cookin' knows how to do a good chocolate. Let's mix it in. We have a few chocolate treats to try today. Since this is my grand return to Lunchbox, if you get this video to... Oh goodness, I don't even know what number. Hold on, I'm gonna look up a number after I pour this. I just didn't want it to harden in this mold. Let's try to level that a little bit. I don't know how I feel about these mousse flavors. Oh, and this is supposed to be cut off. Okay, we're gonna make the oranges next, but I was saying, I gotta go get the chocolates out of the fridge. There are too many things happening at once. I'm saying if you get this video to 1,000 likes, I will make Kuromi cookies for Valentine's. Okay, before we put the orange powder in, I'm gonna go get the chocolates. I am back. The chocolates have hardened. We are going to pop them out. Well, they just fall out. They're looking pretty good. Put a little bit too much chocolate in, so if you're making this kit, be careful. But we're gonna make the orange jelly next. Let me pour this in here. Let's give this a stir. Ooh, this smells good. It's like a marmalade. Yum. Okay, so we pour this into the heart one to make a orange chocolate tart, I believe. Let's do a drop over here. Oh, that looks good. And then we pour the rest over this. But is that enough? Let's do one more dot here. There, that looks good. Okay, and the rest. So we have chocolate orange, which is like one of the best combinations ever, honestly. It's better than chocolate banana. Fight me. Oh no! I forgot to make the little oranges. Can I scoop it out? I think I can. That was close. Okay, the fruit is saved. How many of you noticed that? Everything is fixable for the most part. Finally, we make the caramel sauce. One triangle. This doesn't really smell like anything either. It says caramel cream. Let's make the caramel tart. Almost looks like peanut butter. And they said if there's any left over, you can use it to decorate. Let's try to dome it as much as we can, make it look good. I'm kind of scared to taste this one. It's time to remove the mousse. Let me get the packaging ready. It is time to dish up the sweets. Let's demold the mousse. I wish I'd kept those toothpicks, but it should be okay. I don't want it to go plop. There we go. We're gonna plate it beautifully. Look at that pattern. Okay, this one's a little bit harder because it's a circle. We are professionals. Come on, chocolate mousse, you can do it. Ooh, wait, why does it look so fancy? And then the nama caramel, ooh, chocolate goes here. And then the heart chocolate goes here. Looking good. I need to clean this up a little bit. The star goes on here. Oh, I'm sad that I overfilled the mold because I don't trust myself to trim that without melting all of it. So it's not as pretty, but it's all good. The picture shows the orange slice with the flower leaning on it. Oh, I don't think the caramel's quite hardened. Whoops. It's okay. Whoop. Maybe. Oh, maybe. There we go. Basically, you can decorate it how you want, but I just did it how they did it on the box, so I am basic. Here, I'll do something that they didn't do. The strawberry on the orange. And then we have the powder, the sweet powder. It doesn't smell like anything, but on like chocolate cakes like this, they usually do powdered sugar, so I'm just gonna dot some on. It hides the mess a little bit too. Mine and theirs. Who did it better? Now I have to taste all these. I'm kind of excited. Let's go for the strawberry mousse first. I don't know how I feel about the mousse flavored ones. Whoop. The fondue was better. It's not a bad flavor. It's just, I don't know if it's supposed to be yogurty or not. I can't place the flavor, which is a little unsettling considering it's supposed to be strawberry. The jellies are pretty good. It's just the mousse. That chocolate is okay. I bet this is gonna be good though. So they suggested cutting it like this. I don't think it was gonna pop out like that. Look at that. Huh. I'll give it a go. It's not bad. It reminds me of like a Tootsie Roll, but softer. Interesting. Let me try the caramel chocolate, though I'm a little bit scared of the mousse. I'm just gonna one bite this. It says plenty of calcium. I'm wondering if that's what I'm tasting. I almost wanted to say yogurt, but whatever is in the mousse flavored stuff is just not good. But this definitely was a more complicated kit to make over the fondue kit. They're both very fun kits. I would honestly highly recommend both. They're both chocolate, but they're both very different. So I would say go for the one that looks the most fun to you. I'll try to find some more DIY kits that I haven't done yet, and maybe we can go back to our roots and try some ones that they've renewed. Thank you so much for watching. I'm so excited to be back on this channel. Don't forget, 1,000 likes and I will make Kuromi cookies, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye!